Hey guys, Dr. Axe here, founder of DrAxe.com and Dr. Natural Medicine. In today's video, I'm gonna be going over ginger essential oil, all of its benefits, how to use it on a daily basis, and we'll be talking about, and actually I'll be showing you some of the actually exact products I have. This is actually a ginger essential oil here, and this is something called ginger CO2 extract, which is similar to essential oil, but actually has even more compounds. This is what I recommend mostly for internal use there as well. But let's go ahead and dive in and talk about ginger essential oil. You know, ginger has been used for thousands of years, both in Ayurvedic medicine and Chinese medicine, and the greatest benefits of ginger come from its anti-inflammatory properties due to several compounds, one of those compounds being zingerberine. And so zingerberine is actually the active compound in ginger, similar to curcumin being the active compound in turmeric. And this compound has tremendous benefits. One of the things they would do for people with any type of digestive issues or cold issues, and if somebody has coldness and digestive issues, an example of that would be irritable bowel syndrome or diarrhea in certain cases. But if somebody has those issues, they would have them do ginger tea every morning. So we know ginger, the anti-inflammatory benefits are tremendous. And what I want to go over here today are the 7 benefits of using ginger oil on a daily basis. Now, when using ginger oil, what you can simply do, now if you're buying an essential oil, make sure that it is certified organic or therapeutic grade. You wanna make sure it's a high quality oil. And along with that oil, you also wanna make sure that they've followed organic farming practices at the same time. So what I do with ginger oil is I'll typically just do 1 to 2 drops in a meal and consume it that way. So again, I will do a small amount internally if it's therapeutic grade, but only with food in most cases. But again, CO2 extract ginger oil is also incredible there to use. So let's go ahead and dive in. Number one benefit of ginger oil is digestion. Again, for a lot of people, and within Chinese medicine, your body can be too hot or too cold, too dry or too damp. And so what you typically want to do if somebody has candida or fungal issues or digestive issues, you typically want to lightly warm the body and you want to dry the body. Well, ginger has both of those properties. So again, using ginger is great for digestion, especially with people with SIBO, that's small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, IBS, Crohn's disease, colitis, leaky gut syndrome. All of those digestive conditions can benefit from using ginger oil on a daily basis. Now, the other benefit of ginger is just simply smelling it. You can also add it into a hot tea, just a single drop. Now, you don't want to do too much. Essential oils that contain a lot of these volatile compounds, if you do too large amounts of them, they can actually start to tax the liver and even the digestive tract. But overall, in small amounts, an oil like ginger can be very healthy to do internally. The number two there is inflammation. We know most diseases today are inflammatory in nature. Think about this, anything with an ITIS at the end in Latin means inflammation. So arthritis, that's inflammation of your joints. Ulcerative colitis. Colitis is inflammation of your colon. In fact, heart disease today isn't caused by high cholesterol. Your body lays down cholesterol because you have inflammation in your arteries. So ginger is great for fighting all of those conditions because of the compounds gingerols as well as zingerberine, the anti-inflammatory properties. Now, when you taste ginger root today or any type of ginger, you're gonna notice it has a really strong bite. I'd ask you this question, have you ever done a ginger shot? It really has this kick at the end, that spiciness, that's from zingerberine. The longer you cook ginger in terms of the temperature, the more that starts to fade that compound and actually turns into a different compound. But that's why doing actually raw ginger or things that are cold pressed, like a cold pressed CO2 extract, oftentimes have that really strong ginger bite there at the end. Number three is cancer. You know, ginger, ginger falls in the same family as 2 other herbs, turmeric and galangal, and that entire family of herbs have really powerful anti-cancer properties. In fact, ginger oil and this zingerberine compound is part of a family called sesquiterpenes, which are compounds found in essential oils that have massive anti-cancer properties. They also tend to be very grounding. So if you ever fly anywhere and you tend to get jet lag, doing herbs that are grounding in nature that have that sesquiterpenes properties, such as myrrh oil, A lot of sort of wood and tree oils like cedarwood, vetiver. Those really earthy, woody smelling oils are very grounding to the body as well, and good especially if you're traveling or flying. All right, number four here, malabsorption. You know, a lot of people today aren't actually absorbing the vitamins and minerals they're consuming. And so adding a little ginger oil and some probiotics, upping those in your diet, is gonna help you better absorb vitamins such as vitamin C and vitamin B12. It's also gonna help you absorb more minerals like magnesium and iron. So again, you wanna make sure, again, ginger oil is great for malabsorption. It's also great for nausea. So if a woman is pregnant, they could do a little bit of oftentimes using something like a ginger oil, possibly mixed with a, an oil like sometimes chamomile, sometimes peppermint, but things that really just kind of soothe the body. And with pregnancy, I recommend not internal use, but just simply smelling it, getting a diffuser and just simply smelling it can be really calming to the body there as well. Number six here is, and by the way, for nausea, I love that combination of peppermint oil plus ginger. Really, really great combo there. Number six here is immunity. Now, in Chinese medicine, when you get a cold, have you ever thought about this? Why is a cold called a cold? You know, your nose is running, you have all of this mucus buildup. So why isn't it called something along those lines? It's called a cold. Well, a cold is called a cold because within Chinese medicine, when you get a cold or flu, your body tends to get cold. That's why you tend to sometimes get the chills or you get really hot, is your body is cold internally. Well, ginger is a warming herb, so it helps warm your body, helping you overcome a cold. That's why some of the most ancient remedies include ginger tea with cinnamon, right? So, cinnamon is also a warming herb. So those warming herbs together help warm the body, combating a cold that you can have. So again, ginger, one of my favorite natural immune boosters, especially for the cold and flu. And then diabetes. The other incredible thing here is ginger oil. The compounds have been shown to help balance out insulin levels. Now we know insulin levels is important for hormones. Insulin is important for healthy energy levels. It's also important for fighting diabetes and really supporting those insulin receptor sites on your pancreas. And so again, another great benefit of using ginger oil every day is the insulin balancing, those blood sugar balancing benefits. And so again, if you're gonna use ginger oil, diffuse it in your home. It's great to mix with citrusy oils like lemon and lime. So diffusing that in your house is great. Topically, you want to use a carrier oil with it, such as coconut oil, olive oil, jojoba oil. Those are some good options there because it is a little bit spicy. So again, mixing this with, let's say, 5 drops of ginger oil to about 1/4 of a teaspoon of coconut oil. You can use it topically then, or again, internally, just do a single, typically 1 drop is enough. One to 2 drops you can put in tea, you can add to smoothie there as well. In fact, you could do a cinnamon apple smoothie. I do a scoop of bone broth protein powder that's apple cinnamon flavor, a little bit of ginger there, can taste great. And I've even added this into recipes, apple pie, some other things like that can be great. It's a little ginger oil, and again, ginger CO2 extract, also pretty great here. In fact, when you smell these oils, like I'm smelling now, I mean, it is very, very strong, especially a ginger CO2. So listen, ginger oil is great, but also doing ginger tea, raw ginger juice, ginger CO2 extract, all great ways to get ginger. And hey, if you want to learn more about ginger and other natural remedies and herbs, make sure to subscribe here to my YouTube channel. And we've got a lot more information coming out on essential oils and herbal remedies. And also I've got another article going through, I went through the top 7 here. I actually go through the top 10. If you want to check out the top 10 benefits of ginger, just Google my name, Dr. Axe Ginger Oil. You'll find my article there on draxe.com. Guys, thanks for watching. Hi, Dr. Axe here. I want to say thanks so much for checking out this YouTube video, and also don't forget to subscribe if you want to get more great content on things like herbs, essential oils, natural remedies, and how to use food as medicine. Also, check out more of our content on my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.